Ta-da! So, what am I doing? I'm trying an experiment. Wow! Oh my god! I have a water here. Correct? It's heavy. And this, you know what you call this card, is very, very thin. And yet it supports. My goodness! Wow! Hello friends and welcome to Average Classes. And today we are going to discuss a very, very beautiful concept, that is your atmospheric pressure. What we just saw here now is, the atmospheric pressure was balancing. The atmospheric pressure was giving it an upward forces, which was balancing with the downward forces of the water liquid. And that's why even if there was a thin sheet of paper, it was not falling. And here comes our atmospheric pressure. Okay, so if you are new to the channel and you haven't subscribed yet, please do subscribe. Come on. So now, today we'll be discussing atmospheric. Okay, our atmosphere. Air is what, sir? Air is a fluid. Very good. It has weight. That means what? We all are actually immersed in air. Into the air, isn't it amazing? See, we are actually, we do not swimming. That's a different thing. In case of liquid, we need to swim, okay? But air, it's less density. But if you think properly, actually we all are inserted. We all are inside the air, okay? We are all immersed inside the air. So air is fluid. So air has a weight. That means we have to support the air. We got to support the air column which is above us. Correct. This entire air column, which is in contact with the surface of the earth, exerts a pressure, which is nothing but, we call it as what? Atmospheric pressure. The pressure associated with the atmospheric air surrounded us, we call it atmospheric what? Pressure. We call it atmospheric pressure. Okay. Remember, this atmospheric pressure, it varies with altitude, temperature and local conditions. Now, sir, last class you told P is equal to, sir, rho gh. P equal to rho gh. So, we can find the atmospheric air. We can find the value of atmospheric air by this formula. No, you cannot find. Why, sir? First of all, density of air. Do you know density of air? We know the density of air at sea level, that is 1.3, 1.28 kg per meter cube. But what about density of air which is going up, up, up? It decreases. As the altitude increases, the density of air decreases. Hence, we do not know the rho. G is okay. We call it G constant. Height. What is the depth? What is the height of the atmosphere you are going to take? So that also we don't know. So hence, this formula we cannot use to find the magnitude of atmospheric pressure. Cannot be used to find the magnitude of atmospheric pressure. Means we have to use something else. We have to use some different formula. Okay. So what we are going to do is, we are going to take the help of a barometer. Okay, first what we'll do? Sir, we'll take a glass tube, a simple glass tube. And now we are going to fill the glass tube with mercury. Why mercury? I'll tell you after some time why we are taking mercury. We took a glass tube. In the glass tube, we have immersed the glass tube, means fill the glass tube with the help of a mercury. Okay, samajh mein aa gaya? Pura fill, you have panned it. Okay, now what? You take another container. In the container, again, what you will take, sir? We'll take mercury only. You are sticking to mercury only, sir. Why? Bhai sahab, wait for 5 minutes. Wait for some time. I'll tell you why I'm going for mercury. Okay, this is also we have filled with mercury. Now what we'll do? We have filled it. Suppose imagine this is your tube. You have filled it mercury. Now close it by your thumb. Correct? Tilt it. Insert it. Now keep it what? Vertically. Keep it vertically downward or ulta. Okay? Opposite position. Okay? Or invert it. Invert it and keep it inside the container. What you have done, you have filled it, but you will observe
some mercury will come down, some portion will come down. Now here what you keep? Here what you keep? You keep a scale. Now here you keep a scale, ठीक है? और हम बोलते हैं graduated scale, so that we can measure up to what height, up to what height, what this has come. ठीक है? So now what happened? This is now absolute vacuum, nothing is here. Earlier there was mercury, now the some mercury has slipped inside. So now here nothing, nothing is there means we can write here nothing here, P is equal to zero, it is absolute vacuum here. Nothing is here. What is applying pressure here, sir? Here outside we have atmospheric pressure which is pushing this. ठीक है? Which is applied on the surface of this mercury. Now we have studied before, sir, if it is in a horizontal case, the pressure is same. If it is horizontal, pressure is same. If it is a continuous mass of fluid, so pressure is going to be same. So PA is equal to PV. That's what we have studied. Again, if you have not gone through that, please go through the Pascal's law. It was there in the previous video. Okay, so PA is equal to your PV. Sir, what is PA? What is the pressure at A? Sir, that is atmospheric pressure. So I am writing PATM. PATM is your atmospheric pressure. What is the pressure at B? The pressure at B is because of this column. This column of mercury which is height, which has rose to a height H. This column of mercury which has rose to a height H. Or you can say like this. Sir, here is the pressure zero. Here is atmospheric pressure. So we can calculate the difference in pressure with the help of this column of mercury. That is also correct. No problem. Okay? So PATM equal to PB. PB is because of this. That is density of mercury, G and height of mercury. Density of mercury, G and height of mercury. Sir, how to know the height of mercury? That's why we have a scale here. From this scale, we can measure, okay, up to where the height of mercury has gone. Up to where the height of mercury has gone. So, it has been found experimentally that in such case, your height of mercury was 760 mm. How much? To be precise, 763.3 mm of Hg. To be precise, 763.3 mm of Hg. It has been found experimentally. So now put the formula. What is density? We will write 13,546 kg per meter cube. Multiply G, 9.8. Multiply Hm, 763.3 mm. So you have to convert into meter divided by 1000. So after finding all this, the answer was 101.325 Pascal or Newton per meter square. Pascal or Newton per meter square. This is your standard atmospheric pressure. See, we need to have a standard so that throughout the world, whoever is studying, they can come into a conclusion. You can say in terms of meter of water. Someone else can say meter of air. Someone else can say meter of some liquid. Someone else can say, okay, meter of ethanol or some other liquid. But throughout the world, in order to judge, we should have a standard atmospheric pressure. So the standard atmospheric pressure is 101.325 Pascal or Newton per meter square. I hope you got it. But normally what we are taking is, instead of taking 13,546 or 763.3, we are taking like this. Mercury will take, density of mercury will take 13,600 and height of mercury will come around 760 height of mm. Height of mercury will come around 760 mm of Hg. So this barometric experiment gave you what? The local atmospheric pressure, PATM, or the atmospheric pressure it gave. So atmospheric pressure can safely be written as, okay, pause the video, note it down, I want to erase it. Okay. So atmospheric pressure, now I'll write the atmospheric pressure in this way. Please see. Okay, so what I'll write? So this was conducted by your an Italian scientist. His name is Torricelli. Okay, T-O-R-R-I-C-E-L-L-I. Italian scientist, his name is Torricelli. Okay, so as per him, your one standard atmosphere is nothing but 760 torr. 760 torr on the name of, okay, Italian scientist Torricelli. Or we call it 763.3 mmHg. Sir, we have studied. It is 760 mm of Hg. I am telling you some exact values. But we are human, no? We are engineer, we are very lazy.
What we do? We try to make things as easy as possible. Lazy but easy. Go ahead. Okay.
So, as easy as possible. So, what we do? We normally, we say, we told, ki sir, 1 tor is equal to 1 mm of Hg. We just rounded it off. So, that's why we also telling it, instead of 763 mm of Hg, we are telling how much? Again, we are also saying, sir, 760 mm of Hg. So, we told 1 tor equal to 1 mm of Hg.
Okay. So, they'll ask you, what is the pressure exerted by 760 mm or 76 centimeter or 0.76 meter of mercury? One atmospheric. We call it one standard atmospheric. Okay.
So, 760 mm of Hg. So, how much in terms of Pascal? Pascal, how much we got? 101325 Pascal or 101.325 kilopascal. 1 kilo is nothing but equal to 1000.
Okay, 101.325 kilopascal. 1000 views nahi jata mere videos.
Okay, 101.325 kilopascal. Or we'll convert in terms of bar. 1.01325 bar. Already we have discussed, already from the last class we have discussed, your 1 bar equal to 10 to the power 5 Pascal. 1 bar equal to 10 to the power 5 Pascal. So, this is your SI unit. Bar, kilopascal, Pascal, Newton per meter square, these all are SI unit. Okay. We are studying mostly in terms of SI unit. But those who are already working in some pneumatic systems, you might be familiar with a term known as PSI. PSI is pound per square inch. PSI is what? Pound per square inch. Or you go for US and Europe, they will be talking in PSI only. That is pound per square inch. So if you convert that into pound per square inch, it is 14.696 PSI. What is PSI? Sir, PSI is pound per square inch. If you take 1 square inch of area, 1 skin variable area, how much pressure is acting? 14.696 pound. My God.
Sir, why you are behaving like that? Because it is wow. See this. This is 1 square inch. This much area. This much area is 1 square inch. So, this much 1 square inch of area, the pressure, the force applied is how much? 14.697, 15 pounds nearly, which is it? How much? This much area, how much pressure force is acting on my face? On only this much area? 6.8 kilo. Dark. 6.8 kilo is only working here. Throughout the body, it is the same thing. I mean, my throughout the body, every square inch of the body, I am coming under a pressure force of how much? 6.8 kilo. Wow. I will say this is wow. 1 kilo is equal to around 2.2 pounds. Okay. So, then why I am not crumbling? Why am I totally compressed? Why I am not becoming a, you know, what you call a spear of muscles and bones? Why I am still standing like this? Because I breathe air. I breathe air. We breathe air. We breathe air. Okay. Which is again at atmospheric pressure. So here from inside I am giving air pressure of atmospheric and outside also atmospheric. So skin has nothing much to resist. That's why this creation, this what you call universe, our earth is amazing. It is amazing. Otherwise, imagine I do not have this much to resist. What will happen? I would have crumbled. 7 kilo force, dude. My God, it's too good. Too high. To get you a little more excited. Okay, you can pause and note it down. Okay? Please, do pause and note it down. I'm going to erase it. Okay. So, to give you one more idea. See, you take a 1 meter by 1 meter table. You take a 1 meter by 1 meter table. I just want to tell ki how much force is the atmospheric. Atmospheric pressure, kitna force laga raha hai humare upar. Okay. You take the 1 meter by 1 meter table. Okay. This is 1 meter. This is also 1 meter. This table has 4 legs. Okay. It has 4 legs. Obviously. Okay. So, how much pressure, I told you, force is acting on this table?
top of the table, I told how much? One atmospheric. Now imagine 1 meter square. If a 1 meter square, so how much force is acting in here? Sir, it is 101325 Pascal. Okay? 101325 Pascal. You just round it. We are rounding it to 10 to the power 5 Pascal. Okay? On 1 meter square, I ask him, like the force is asking, sir, are baba, pressure equal to force per area. Okay? So force equal to how much? Pressure into area. Okay? Your pressure is 100. I took 10 to the power 5. Area is 1. Okay, so how much force sir? 10 to the power 5 Newton. Force is equal to here nothing but weight, self weight, m into g, 10 to the power 5 Newton. I want mass equal to 10 to the power 5 gravity, take 10. How much? 10 to the power 4. That means see how much? 10 ton. What is the pressure? It is acting on this 1 meter by 1 meter table. 1 meter by 1 meter. This much only table. How much? 10,000 kilo. The force applied here is 10,000 kilo. Then sir, why it is not breaking? Okay. To give you an idea, 10,000 kilo, it's around how many? Or 10 cars. Around how many cars? 10 cars. So on top of this, how much you are keeping? How many car you can keep? 10 ton of car, 10 cars you can keep. Or, take two baby elephant. Now you may, agree with me, or you'll, why I'm so excited you'll come to know. It's like I'm carrying two baby elephants on my shoulder. One baby elephant, on top of that, one more baby elephant. Now try to imagine. That much weight your air pressure is acting on us. Okay, but the beauty thing is it's fluid. If you have studied Pascal's law, they apply pressure in all the direction. Okay, so if there is top pressure of 10,000 kilo, so bottom also same, left, right, everywhere it is same. That's why it is balanced. The other day one guy asked, sir, now we are in a schoolroom, the height is only 10 meter. So whether the air pressure will be less, no way, it will be same everywhere, it is connected throughout the atmosphere, the pressure is same. That is 101.325 your Pascal. You tell me that there is no opening. Okay, you are inside a cylinder or a chamber where it is not at all connected to anywhere, and you started compressing, then we can manipulate with the pressure. But you are in a schoolroom, there are doors, windows everywhere, even a small opening is there. So it is connected to atmospheric pressure. So you are only connected to atmospheric pressure. So don't think that in a room the pressure will be less, it will go out, the pressure will be more, nothing like that. Atmospheric pressure is same throughout everywhere in India, okay, in USA, in Europe, wherever you go, the atmospheric pressure is going to be same. Standard atmospheric pressure is going to be same. What? Standard atmospheric pressure is going to be same. Already I have told you, the atmospheric pressure varies with altitude, temperature and local conditions. Okay? So, isn't it wow? So, that's the beauty of your science. That's the beauty of our nature. Okay? So, even if we are acted upon by a 10 ton amount of force, still, okay, our body in such a way that it balances it. ठीक है आगे समझ में. सो दिस इज योर एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर. सो इफ समवन आस्क यू व्हाट इज वन एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर, व्हाट डिड यू से सर, इट इज 101.325 पास्कल और 101.325 किलो पास्कल और 1.01325 बार और 14.696 psi, दैट इज पाउंड पर स्क्वायर इंच, और इक्विवेलेंट टू 760 टॉर और 760 mm of Hg. ओके, गुड, समझ में आ गया. वेरी गुड, वेरी वेरी गुड. ओके, ठीक है. नाउ ओके, पॉज द वीडियो एंड नोट इट डाउन प्लीज. आई एम गोना इरेज इट, सो पॉज द वीडियो एंड नोट इट डाउन. आवर स्टडी ऑफ एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर टू लर्न सम न्यू स्टफ्स. ओके, सो द फर्स्ट विल टेक लाइक, व्हाट इज द वेट ऑफ योर एटमॉस्फेयर. ठीक है, इंटरेस्टिंग. Now, how sir, how will you calculate weight of the atmosphere? Obviously, we can calculate. Just now, we have to say the pressure exerted by the atmosphere is nothing but because of the air. Okay, gravity pulls the air. ठीक है. सो द सेल्फ वेट द टोटल सम टोटल ऑफ ऑल द वेट ऑफ द एयर इज अप्लाइंग प्रेशर दैट्स ओनली पीक पीक ऑफ द फोर्स पर एरिया. सो टू आंसर योर फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन क्वेश्चन नंबर वन पी इज इक्वल टू हियर राइट वेट ऑफ द एटमोस्फियर पर एरिया. सो व्हाट इज योर वेट वेट इक्वल टू सर पी इंटू ए. तो वेट इक्वल टू पी पी इज व्हाट
प्रेशर.
प्रेशर इज हाउ मच वी फाउंड एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर सर
101325
पास्कल मल्टीप्लाई एरिया. व्हाट एरिया सर ऑल द एरिया सरफेस एरिया व्हिच इज इन कॉन्टैक्ट विद द एटमोस्फियर व्हिच इज इन कॉन्टैक्ट विद द एटमोस्फियर दैट इज व्हाट एरिया सरफेस एरिया ऑफ अर्थ. सरफेस एरिया ऑफ द अर्थ अर्थ इज अ स्फीयर अर्थ इज अ स्फीयर. सो हाँ व्हाट इज द सरफेस एरिया ऑफ अ स्फीयर फॉर्मूला 4/3 पाई आर क्यू. सर वी डू नॉट नो द रेडियस ऑफ अर्थ सी इट्स अ जीके क्वेश्चन ओके इट इज 6371 किलोमीटर आई थिंक ओके. So this implies W equal to 101325 multiplied by 4/3 into pi. R is 6371 kilometer. Convert it to meter. It's cube. ठीक है. So the weight of the atmosphere is a massive 5.168228262 into 10^19. Ooh, Newton. Wow. 10^19 okay after 0.5 or 336 10 zeros after this means 5168228 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 whoo this much newton is your weight of the atmosphere total weight of the atmosphere interesting yes or no baba yes sir it is interesting now second is द मैक्सिमम हाइट दैट द वॉटर कैन सपोर्ट इन अ स्ट्रॉ. ठीक है यू हैव टू कट स्ट्रॉ वेरी बिग स्ट्रॉ यू हैव टू लेट अस से सो इट कैन नॉट बी इन्फिनिटी ऑब्वियसली ओके इट हैज टू बी अ डेफिनेट लेंथ. सो व्हाट इज द मैक्सिमम हाइट ऑफ वॉटर कॉलम कैन बी सपोर्टेड थ्रू अ स्ट्रॉ. सी यू टेक कोकोनट वॉटर यू ड्रिंक थ्रू स्ट्रॉ. ठीक है करेक्ट यस और नो. और यू ड्रिंक कोला लस्सी लस्सी तो हम ऐसे पी लेते हैं बट वट एवर यू ड्रिंक सो मेनी स्टफ जूस यूजिंग योर स्ट्रॉ. सो माई द क्वेश्चन हियर इज वॉट इज द मैक्सिमम वॉटर कॉलम कैन बी सपोर्टेड थ्रू अ स्ट्रॉ कैन बी सपोर्टेड थ्रू अ स्ट्रॉ. ठीक है सी यू हैव टू कन कोकोनट वॉटर ओके यू हैव टू कोकोनट वॉटर एंड यू आर ड्रिंकिंग थ्रू दिस यू आर ड्रिंकिंग थ्रू द coconut water okay what can be the maximum height okay here it is coconut water otherwise we can go for water here the question they have asked is coconut water sorry question they have asked is water column okay so what you do is when you are trying to drink through this coconut water first you try to suck it yes or no that means what you are doing whatever the air here you are taking that air out first you are taking the air out first. So what happened here you are trying to create a vacuum inside your mouth. ठीक है so here you have atmospheric pressure because it is open to atmosphere. So here you have atmospheric pressure here it is less pressure. I don't know you cannot go for absolute zero but you have gone some you know less pressure. So now because of the delta P the water or the coconut water or a cola or juice or lassi will rise in the straw. Rise in the straw. The question they are asking how much it can rise, how much it can support. What scale height of atmosphere? The maximum height of water that can be supported in a straw. That is the question. Very easy. You have already know P18 equal to rho gh and h of water. Now h of water equal to P18 101325 by density 1000 gravity 9.8 gravity. 9.8. See interesting thing I'll tell you. If you put this, how much you are getting? 10.34 meter. 10.34 meter. You check it. You check in your calci. If instead of 9.8, if instead of 9.8, if you are taking 9.81, this answer will be 10.33. Here you'll get 10.339. So that's why I wrote 10.34. Here you'll get 10.328. So I'll write 10.33 meter. Then sir, which one is correct? Which one is more correct? If both are there in the option, go with this. Go with 10.33 meter in your exam. If both options are there. because it is 9.81 is more little correct. Okay, so what is the maximum height of water column that can hold in a straw? 10.34 meter. What if, sir, I want a bigger column, water column? Then you cannot always think the atmosphere will do all your work. You have to apply pressure, then only you can get more than 10.34 meter. But only if atmospheric pressure is there, it can hold up to 10.3 meter of water column. Okay, through a straw, through anything, 10.34 meter of water column. Got it? Got the second answer? Yes or no? Very, very good. Interesting. Okay, now third. The scale height of atmosphere assuming constant density. What is your P? PATM here equal to rho air G into H air. This implies H of air column equal to 101,325. See, initially only I told we cannot do that because density is changing. That's why we do not know what is the, how the density is changing or what is the height of the air column. We don't know that. Okay, I am trying to prove that through this problem. I am trying to prove why this particular question number 3 cannot be answered or it is wrong. Okay, so density of air, sir, 1.28 kg per meter cube into what is this? G is 9.8. You will get an answer nearly this, 7.95 kilometer you will get. Try 7.95 kilometer you will get. Means what I am trying to prove a point is, if the density of air is constant and to apply a pressure of 101.325, that is atmospheric pressure, what will be the air column? Air column will be 7.95 kilometer. Water column is 10.34 meter, air column is 7.95 kilometer, kilometer up. That's what I am trying to make a point. But it is false. Why false, sir? Sir, this is nothing but nearly equal to 26,000 feet. Your aeroplanes, commercial aeroplanes, I am not talking about fighter aircraft, commercial aeroplanes fly at a height greater than 30,000 feet. We travel more than 30,000 feet and we have air there. That's not the space. Hence, it is pakka and sure that density of air is not constant. So this assuming constant density is false. Density of air cannot be constant through the atmosphere. What is the height? Sir, it is much greater than 30,000 feet, 60,000 feet. When you have 1 lakh feet also, we have atmosphere. Okay. Even more than that also, we have atmosphere. That means what? Density is not constant. So density is not constant, and density, what happened? Density decreases. That's why only your H is increasing. That's P equal to rho GH. Density inversely proportional to your depth. Imagine your H, when you are increasing the H, what happens? Your density decreasing. Or your density decreasing, that's why your H is increasing. Height of the atmosphere. Are you getting my point? What I am trying to say is, okay, you cannot assume density to be constant. If you assume density of air to be constant in the atmosphere, you will end up with the atmospheric height of 7.95 kilometer, which is false. To get you the feel of the subject, only I told that our commercial aeroplanes fly more than 30,000 feet. Fighter aircraft fly at 50,000-60,000 feet. Are you getting my point? That's why the assuming constant density itself is wrong. So air is much above the 7.95 kilometer. Okay. So as we go up in the air, your density decreases. That is your question number 3. Okay. Now coming to fourth. What the fourth said? Sir, why mercury only used in the barometer? Why I cannot go for water? Why, sir? First, why? Because density, number one. Because mercury has high density. See, because mercury has high density, what is the tube is sufficient to measure the pressure? Sir, only 76 centimeter or 760 mm or 0.76 meter of mercury column is sufficient to measure me pressure. So I can measure large amount of pressure without, you know, going for bigger and bigger tube. If I'll have to go for water,
I have, for the same amount of pressure, I have to use nearly 13 times the bigger tube. Imagine 10.34 meter bigger than this roof. This much big tube you need. Okay, you got it. So, first is density, that's why. Okay, second is it's opaque in nature. It's opaque. Because it is opaque in nature, mercury is opaque, that is shiny. So, you can read, you can tell, okay, 104.8 thermometer may be clear. Otherwise, okay, 76 centimeter. So, because it is in opaque in nature, you can read. The readability increases. The readability of your value is more. So, second was that. Third is what, sir? Vaporization. Mercury do not vaporize. Okay, mercury na, does not. Mercury does not vaporize. That means it has low vapor pressure. Because it has low vapor pressure, it's not vaporizing and I can get the correct reading. What if it vaporized? Already, let us say the 2 cm of mercury has vaporized and instead of 50 cm, I am reading 48 cm. So, it's a faulty reading. It's an error reading. So, mainly because of these three, we are using mercury in the barometer. That is the density. Higher density, remember, which density? Density is higher and low vapor pressure. Higher density, low vapor pressure, and it is opaque in nature. Shining means readability increases. Understood? Very, very good. Super duper good. Now, pause the video and note it down. Coming to our next topic, which is your types of pressure. Or, measurement of pressure actually mostly through your manometer and all will do, but just I am giving an idea, okay, when the types of pressure through measurement, okay, when the measurement of pressure is done with respect to absolute zero. What is absolute zero, sir? Complete vacuum space. So let me show you with an example. Let us say this is your absolute zero line. This is your absolute zero line. So when we are measuring a particular pressure with respect to absolute zero, we call it as what? Absolute pressure. We call it as absolute pressure. Okay. So this is always measured with respect to absolute zero. Like above, always the pressure is absolute. More than absolute zero. That means it is always positive. The absolute pressure always you will get is a positive. So, always the pressure measurement is done above the absolute zero. Let us take one point I am taking here. Okay. This is, let us say, one pressure. P absolute. Or somewhere here also I am taking a pressure. Okay. That is also what? Above, right? It is above. P absolute. Okay, P absolute or allow me to write it on this side. Okay, P absolute. Okay, P absolute. Okay, so it's always measured. So I have took two pressures. Okay, I have took two pressure which is measured above the absolute zero and both are your absolute pressure. Okay, good. Now, if you are going to measure the pressure, when the measurement of pressure is done with respect to atmospheric pressure, atmospheric pressure is also known as what? Gauss zero. Gauss or Gauss, how you are pronouncing, up to you. Also, it is known as Gauss zero. So, if I measure with respect to atmospheric pressure, just now we have studied atmospheric pressure. If we will measure with respect to which pressure? Will measure with respect to your atmospheric pressure. Let us say this is my atmospheric, PATM. This is my atmospheric pressure. If it is measured with respect to atmospheric pressure, we call it as what? Gauge pressure. We call it as gauge pressure. Sir, I didn't understand. You ride bike, scooty, something. You go to a petrol pump, bunk or somewhere and you ask the guy to fill the air. He'll set around 32 PSI. Or 34 PSI he'll say. What is that pressure? That is gauge pressure. That is gauge pressure measured with respect to atmosphere. That means that is 32 or 34 gauge pressure na, that is above the atmosphere. That is above the atmosphere means atmospheric pressure is there. Irrespective of the atmospheric pressure, you have already also 32 or 34 psi extra pressure on in your tire. Extra pressure in your tire. Okay. So when the pressure measured is above the atmospheric pressure, so this pressure is what? Above the atmospheric pressure, we call it positive gauge pressure. We call it as what? Positive gauge pressure. If the measured pressure is below the atmospheric, this is what? Positive gauge, P gauge, which is positive. P gauge, which is positive. If the measured pressure, see this particular pressure, we are in, initially we took two pressure, right? One is here, one is here. So if it is below the atmospheric, we call it negative gauge. We call it as what? Negative gauge pressure. Sir, is it pressure negative? Pressure cannot be negative. Negative gauge pressure means the pressure is below atmospheric. The pressure is below atmospheric. What you are trying to do? You are sucking it. Okay, you are trying to decrease the pressure. You are trying to making it vacuumizing. So we call it negative pressure. Negative gauge pressure or vacuum pressure or suction pressure. Negative gauge pressure, the what do you call negative gauge pressure or vacuum pressure or what? Suction pressure or suction pressure. Positive is positive gauge only, no name. But if it is negative, we call it vacuum pressure or negative gauge pressure or suction pressure. See, these are the key words you have to keep in your mind while writing in exam. In exam, it said, okay, the pressure is 30, vacuum pressure is 30 mm of Hg, means negative. Or the suction pressure created is 20 mm of Hg, negative. Negative, understood. So, negative gauge pressure or vacuum pressure or suction pressure. Now, that means what? Atmospheric, it took a reference, na? It took atmosphere as a reference. See, it measured either above or below the atmospheric pressure as a datum. So, datum reference is what? Atmospheric pressure. Anything is reference, what we normally assign the value? Zero. What we normally assign the value? Zero. So, what is atmospheric gauge pressure if someone asks you? What? Someone will ask you, what is atmospheric gauge pressure? Say, ATM pressure. 101325 Pascal atmospheric gauge pressure. How much? Zero. Because we are taking it as the gauge pressure with respect to atmosphere is zero. Okay, we are taking it reference. So keeping zero in mind, anything is positive, positive gauge pressure, negative below zero, negative gauge pressure. That doesn't mean ki pressure is negative. That means pressure is below atmospheric. Pressure is below atmospheric. Okay, pressure is below atmospheric. So hence, now to make out, like what you call, in order to avoid the confusion of this, we take the absolute pressure. So in this case, what will be the absolute pressure? Here the P absolute equal to, in this case the absolute pressure will be how much? Your P atmospheric minus P gauge. This is your P atmospheric. Okay, that is your P atmospheric. So P absolute equal to P atmospheric pressure minus the gauge pressure. Here P absolute equal to P absolute equal to P atmospheric plus P gauge. P atmospheric plus P gauge. Hence, absolute pressure, your P absolute equal to P ATM plus or minus P gauge. P ATM plus or minus P, not PADM, P atmospheric plus or minus P gauge pressure. If it is gauge pressure is positive plus, if gauge pressure is negative minus, you find the absolute pressure, whatever they have asked in your exam. Understood? Are you getting my point, what I am trying to say here? Yes or no? Okay, I will do two numericals so that your doubt will be clear. Now pause the video and note it down, please. Pause the video and note it down. So let us try to solve this problem to understand the absolute pressure. Okay. So the question asks, what is the, they asked total pressure. They didn't ask gauge pressure or only pressure. They asked total pressure. Suppose instead of this, they would have written, what is the gauge pressure?
for what is the pressure, then it's fine. But they have asked total pressure. Hence, it means we need to calculate the absolute pressure by ocean water column of 50 meter. So, let us say this is your surface of the ocean. Okay? And pura water is here. They are asking, suppose you have a ship or a submarine or a boat, some kind of stuff here, which is 50 meter depth. Then, what is the pressure on this submarine, they are asking? How much is the total pressure on this submarine? See, it's like, you know, the hydrostatic pressure now, which is inside, they'll crush you. They'll crush because the pressure is too high. Even human being, we cannot go inside. We cannot go inside without having a oxygen mask or a proper, suit. Take care. So your divers are there, na? Which are going scuba divers. We are going more deep into deep. What happens? As the depth goes down, the pressure increases. So in order to balance with that, they will breathe pressurized air. In order to balance the pressure with the, you know, outside, whatever the pressure you have, water pressure, which is very high. Okay, very, very high. Again, I'm telling. See this. So we'll first calculate your gauge pressure, P gauge. Sir, P gauge equal to rho G H. We have already studied. So what is ocean water, sea water density? It is around 1030 kg per meter cube. Gravity 9.81. Okay, how much is the depth they have given? 50 meter in the depth. So, if we'll solve it, please cross check and let me know. Is it 505215 Pascal? Are you getting this much value? Use your gate calci, gate virtual calci you use. And you tell me, is it 505215 Pascal? Okay, nearly around that, I think. Okay, I have done it little back, so I forgot the value. So this much Pascal. What is this? Gauge pressure. So gauge pressure of five bar. Gauge pressure of how much? 5.05215 bar. This much pressure is only, you know, below the 50 meter depth. So what is the total pressure? What is above this? Above is what? Atmosphere. So atmosphere is there. Again you have a gauge pressure of 50 meter, that is 5.05 bar. Okay, so what is the total pressure? The total pressure or the absolute pressure is equal to, what is this? Above atmospheric. So P atmospheric plus P gauge. P atmospheric plus P gauge. What is your P atmospheric? 101325 plus 505215. So nearly equal to 6.06 bar. This much is the total pressure acting on it. That's why your scuba divers or whoever diver they are going, right? They have a cylinder, oxygen cylinder, they breathe. It's pressurized. It is pressurized. Got it. So understood. Gauge pressure and atmospheric pressure. So if you'll go up, this is going down the river or ocean or liquid media. If you'll go up, pressure decreases. So it will be minus P gauge. Understood, na? Okay. So with this, we have come to almost the end of the class. I want all of you to try the experiment we started at the beginning of the class. That means to understand the atmospheric pressure, take a glass. Okay, glass full of water, complete it, take a card, it should not be more thick enough, okay, it should be okay thickness, you take this, correct, now pressurize it so that it is, adhering to the water, tilt it, then slowly remove your hand, you see now it is sticking, sir, until what it will stick, until the, air starts coming in, if there is some leakage, then what? Air pressure, atmospheric air will push the water and now the total pressure is more than the upward pressure and it will come down. There is some leakage are there. I want all of you to please try this beautiful experiment and let me know in the comment box, okay, whether you have got success or not. So here is it. Thank you. Wish you a great day. Padhai karte raho. Okay. And please do subscribe to the channel. Have a great day ahead.